អង្គុយចុះអង្គជំនួយរះប្រកាសបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការនីតិវិធីសមការឲ្យប្រឡូវការជូនទៅសហវិញ្ញារងអន្តរជាតិដើម្បីបន្តការតាំងសំណួរនៅដល់ជាពុស្សសាស្ត្រី
Thank you, Mr. President.
Sum akun lok pathean.
Mr. Witness, we were talking about the arrests that you witnessed of two of your superiors. You described what you saw that day at Boring Prayup. The people who came to arrest them, were they armed? Did they have weapons?
កំភ្លើងឬក៏មានអាវុធអីមកជាមួយដែរទេពេលមកចាប់បងនឹមនឹងបងសាឡៅនឹងគេមានកំភ្លើងមកជាមួយមកបួនប្រាំនាក់បាទពួកមកនឹងខ្ញុំនៅនឹងដែរព្រោះមកដល់នឹងហើយនឹមនឹងថាមកជួបខ្ញុំបន្តិចហើយបងនឹមនឹងក៏គាត់ចេញទៅក៏ចាប់ចងយកហ្មងបាទ
All right, you've told testified that you were in battalion 314 of division 310 of the logistics battalion, and that's confirmed by your biography. There are a few battalion 314 cadres who appear in the records from S21 that I would like to ask you about.
With
your leave, Mr. President, I'd like to provide to the witness a document from S21, a list of prisoners from Division 310. It appears in document E3/2592,
E3/2592.
The two people I'd like to ask you about appear on the first page of this document, Mr. Witness. Let's start with first with number 28 on this list. Number 28 on this list of prisoners from Division 310 is a person of Va, B, identified as the secretary of Battalion 314, who entered S21 on the 5th of May 1977. Your Honors, he also appears as number 13-294. On the OCIJ list, 13-294 on the OCIJ list. The person that I've circled, number 28, is down at the bottom of my first page. Do you remember this person who is identified as the secretary of Battalion 314?
The
second person on the same list is the person who appears at number 14 on S21 E3/2592, and the name of this person is Mok Yi Hung, alias Nim. He's described in this list as a battalion office assistant responsible for logistics, who entered S21 on the 8th of May 1977. And the same person also appears as number 4701 on the OCIJ list, 4701. on the OCIJ S-21 list where he's identified as the Assistant Chief of the Battalion 314 Logistics Office. This person who appears at number 14, whose alias is Nim, is this the same person that you described in your testimony? The Nim, who was the deputy chief of your unit?
Ba, mok nom nong dai ba.
And just so we're clear, is this the same Nim whose arrest you witnessed at Bon Krayup? That you just described earlier this afternoon. Thank you. Your Honours, for the record, Nim also appears number 9 in an S-21 list of 198 prisoners who were smashed on the 10th of June 1977. That is document E3/2132. Again, Nim is number 9 on that execution list. I also ask you a few questions about some of the people who you had worked with at Prayakhet Malay Hospital. Do you know whether any of the people, your fellow workers from Prayakhet Malay Hospital
ពេលនោះកងពលបីរយដប់នឹងត្រូវគេរំសាយពួកខាងនិរដីនឹងគេមកក្តោបក្តាប់គឺពេទ្យប្រកេតមាលាធ្វើការជាមួយគ្នានឹងគឺបាត់ខ្លួនអស់មិនដឹងគេផ្លាស់ទៅខាងណាដកទៅខាងណាខ្ញុំអត់បានដឹងដែរព្រោះអត់ដែរបានជួបគ្នាឡើយអត់ដែរឃើញគ្នាព្រោះពេលនោះគេមិនសាយពីគ្នាអស់លីងបាទ
And the people who disappeared from Prayakhet Malay Hospital, were these people who, like yourself, had originally come from the North Zone, Zone 304?
I
think we're talking about the same zone. Do you recall that the central zone, before it was called the central zone, it was originally known as the north zone or zone 304? Do you recall that or have you forgotten that?
Thank
you, Mr. Witness. Do you know what happened to wives and relatives of the leaders of Division 310, such as the wife of Division 310 Secretary Un. Do you know what happened to wives and relatives after the leaders of the Division 310 were arrested?
ខ្ញុំ
ពេលនោះអត់ដឹងដែរគាត់ដល់ឮតគ្នាថាប្រពន្ធមេបញ្ជាការនឹងគេចាប់អស់ដែរហើយយកទៅជាមួយប្តីដែរបាទ
I've provided to you earlier the OCIJ interview of the fellow medic who worked with you at Prayakat Malay,
Jorn,
and I want to read to you another excerpt from his interview. This is again Khmer ERN 0341 3 724 3 7 2 4 through 7 2 6 7 0 4 1 7 9 0 through 7 9 0 and English 0 3 4 5 9 5 3 4 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1 7 9 0 3 4 1
interview.
He's discussing here the hospital question. Was so the hospital chairman until the fall of the regime? Answer, so stayed as the hospital chairman until approximately late 1976. I heard later on that he had been sent for a study course and he just disappeared. After Sao had disappeared, Vun, a female, became the hospital chairwoman. Vun was the wife of Un, the commander of Division 310. People told one another that So had been arrested by the Angkar. Following So's arrest, the hospital staff members were arrested one after another. And then, continuing a few questions later. By the time Un, Division 310 commander, was arrested, Vun, Un's wife and the chairwoman of Ang Duong Hospital was also arrested following Un's arrest. End of quote. Do you remember the wife of Division 310 Commander Un, and do you remember whether she worked for a period as the chairwoman of the Division 310 Hospital? Did you ever meet her?
Ta luk thlop chup kwat te.
Pel nong dai chup kwat dai to kwat neak thom khnyom chea bokkalak toch taach ot dai hien tau nyei leing sdai chmuoy kwat te ba.
Fair enough, Mr. Witness. Your Honor, for the record, Mr. Witness, I want to turn now to your own arrest. Counsel for the defense has asked you some questions about your arrest already. I want to ask you a few follow-ups. You testified that you were put in a truck and taken to an office where you stayed for 2 or 3 days. During those 2 or 3 days, were you shackled, handcuffed, or tied up?
គេឃុំខ្លួនអត់ឲ្យដើរទៅណាឲ្យនៅមកកន្លែងគេថាចាំអង្ការគេមកប្រជុំនឹងយកមិត្តទៅហើយបាទអញ្ចឹងគេអត់ឲ្យខ្ញុំដើរទៅណាទេព្រោះឲ្យនៅមកកន្លែងហ្នឹងបាទ
I understand that you were ordered to remain there. Were you put in handcuffs or were you tied up while you were in this office waiting for
the
Ankar?
នៅក្នុងការិយាល័យនឹងរងចាំអង្ការនោះ
គេចាក់នៅក្នុងកតុបអត់ឲ្យដើរទៅណាមកណាគេចាក់សោជាប់បាទក្រែគាត់សោកតុបនឹងវាមានធ្វើប្រអួចដែកគេឲ្យយើងមើលក្រៅឃើញតែគេអត់ឲ្យទៅណាចេញអត់រួចទេបាទ
let me read to you an excerpt from your DC CAMand English 002512255
This is from your
DC camp review. Question. When you arrived at the prison, did they point any guns at you? Answer. No.There were no guns. They asked me if I worked with any Yun. Vietnamese spies called KGB. I said I just cured people. I didn't have any connections. They asked if I received any indoctrination. I said no. I just did what I was told to do.
គ្រាន់តែថាមីគេឲ្យធ្វើអីខ្ញុំធ្វើអញ្ចឹងទៅហើយបន្តមកទៀតនៅខាងក្រៅ
បន្តិច
ខ្ញុំដេកនៅទីនោះមួយយប់ហើយនៅព្រឹកឡើងគេមកដល់គ
ាត់ claim that I wasn't involved in any activity in our
សកម្មភាពខូចដល់ប៉ាយើងទេគេនិយាយអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំក៏អត់ចាប់អារម្មណ៍ថាមកកន្លែងគុកកន្លែងឯដែរស្មានថាគ្រាន់តែផ្លាស់មកកន្លែងហ្នឹង
Question.
Samnua.
Were you handcuffed?
គេអត់មានដាក់ខ្នោះដាក់អីទេឆ្លើយអត់ទេ
It was just that they didn't care about our meals.
បាយទឹកអីគេអត់យកចិត្តទុកដាក់យើង
មួយថ្ងៃហ្នឹងអត់បាយហើយមិនដឹងទៅហូបអីណា But they went out ចំពោះពួកគេវិញគេទៅហូបទៅចំណែកយើងចេះតែអង្គុយចាំមើលទៅថាតើគេផ្លាស់ទៅណា Yeet came the next day. ព្រឹកដល់ពេលល្ងាចស្អែកឡើង
បានឃើញតាយ៉ាទៅ
End of quote.
សូមចាប់ការដកស្រង
់I just want to confirm Mr. Witness, is it correct that you weren't provided any meals while you were at this office
and
that the people who worked at the office would leave and leave you there when they went to go have their meals? Is that correct?
When they went to have their meals, they left us there, right? Because they didn't have any meals.ហើយខ្ញុំចេះអត់មានចាប់ផ្លឹកថាគេនឹងយកមកដាក់កន្លែងហ្នឹងក៏មិនដឹងថាគេយកមកធ្វើអីបាយក៏គេអត់គិតគូរពេលហ្នឹងនៅបាយរួមព្រោះគេមានបាយរបបកាលណាយើងទៅគេមិនយកឲ្យយើងយើងមានបាយណាហូបជំនាន់ហ្នឹងសិតបាយរបបព្រៀងខ្លួនមួយចានមួយចានបាទ
And you've said this a few times during your testimony that you didn't know that you were at a prison office. And you said in the statement I just read that you thought that you were there a couple of days. that you had been sent to this new office to work, and that you didn't realize you were at a prison office until Yeet showed up. Is that correct?
Yeet mau phang khluon chang men te
ba pel nong yeet mau phang hang khluon pel yeet nong doh tau ban yeet nong yei prab ban dang khluon ba.
And when you were released from this office, how did you return to your unit? How were you transported back to your unit? Did you go back with Yeet, or did you go separate? Can you tell the court how it is that you were released and transported back to your unit?
Pel the lap to wing nung, yet nung got mouth of thrying, yet nung got loop yo to wing ba.
And what time of day was it? Was it during the daytime or at night time when he came to get you?
Pel ngay pel jup, no pel the jeet mouth nung at that got mouth pina.
Pel bong yet mau yo nung got mau pel ngay trăng. Ngay trăng nung pel got nom doh srai chánh mong bay seal ban got đục tới vinh ba.
So when you left at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, can you describe a little about what the building looked like, what the premises, what the area looked like that you left with Yeet at 3 o'clock that day?
We are at mean line la hall held the line gate or tea, set the mean sow mean to be a bar.
I want to read to you an excerpt from your OCIJ interview
about
the time that you were arrested and brought to this office. Your Honors, this is E3-7877, Khmer 00342-436-437. A French 00411-785. English 00346-979. And you're describing here the time at which you were arrested. Quote, at that time, I lived at Anlong Ka Nian, an American 4x4 SUV with covered roof, but no number plate came to pick us up. They did not tie me up when I was on the vehicle. Then the vehicle stopped at Bung Sayab to pick up another two men. They dropped us at an office that I do not know what office it was. End of quote. When you testified to OCIJ, you didn't mention a tool slang in that interview, and in the statement I just read, you said you did not know the office where you were detained for a couple of days. Is it correct that you don't know
what office you spent these 2 days or so in? Is that correct?
pel nong ku oi khnyom sang sai pruh ke ot mien prao jeung ke ot mien lavi lavol jeung jeung khnyom nup tha khluon khnyom trou mien tos hoy pruh ke pruh khnyom khnong kong puol nong sat ta kong puol kbot phong ke tok khnyom tha chea neak kbot dai hoy ba
The reason I'm asking you about this is I want to get some clarification. You were asked yesterday, and you read a quote from your DC CAM interview where you mentioned tool slang, and you were asked by counsel why you said you were at tool slang in your DC CAM interview. And this is the answer you gave yesterday, and you've given essentially the same answer here today. You said, after people were placed at that prison charged by Ol, those people would be further sent to tool slang. End of quote. Do I understand correctly that the office where you were located, which was run by Ol, was not part of tool slang, but that some of the people at this office, as you understand it, were sent further on to tool slang? Do I understand your testimony correctly?
Bà bịa nông trầm trời của tàu tua sáng cái men chập vô tàu đò mà non tết của cái châu cái lại nhân sân bằng cái chun tàu đò cái lại nhung bà
and just to make sure we're clear on this your honors I'd like to provide to the witness a photograph of the wall that surrounded the tool slang prison.
This is 8063.95.
Let me repeat, E3/8063.95. With your leave, I'll provide that to the witness and display it. We can also display it on the screen.
បាទអរគុណអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យផ្នែកសុទោះចាក់បង្ហាញនៅឯកសារអមញ្ញមិញនេះលើអេក្រង់ទូរទស្សន៍តាមសំណើសុំរបស់ស្ថាបនិកនៃរោងអន្តរជាតិ
Now, in this photograph that we're looking at, we see a, on one side, what is a corrugated fence, and on the right side is an iron wrought fence, and between it, a large amount of barbed wire. My question for you, the office where you were held for 2 or 3 days, was it in a compound that was surrounded by a fence like this that had barbed wire?
Pel ke khom khluon khom pi 3 thai nong ku labong dai ke at dak labong luoh te tae labong dai nong pa sanasok ke yiem chung veng ba ta hien yothia ke yiem chung veng ke at ao yeung da la het lahot ba
I understand. My question is, did you see barbed wire? Did you see a perimeter to this compound that had both an outer fence and an inner fence, and in between circles of barbed wire? Did you see anything like that?
pel ke yo tau nung a nung klai khom kayalai nung a mien labong e ke mien ta labong ni chum veng ke chak sao hai nung yo thia ke nau yiem chum veng labong luh nung to la tau klai kok tua slai man mien ba
What do you mean when you were sent to
Tulsa?
We're talking here about the office where you run by Ol, where you spent 2 days. Do I understand correctly that there was no fence like this with barbed wire at the office run by Ol?
Is that correct?
And council asked you this yesterday, but I just want to make sure.
ពីកាលពីក្តីបានសួរលោកតាពីម្សិលមិញហើយប៉ុន្តែខ្ញុំចង់បញ្ជាក់ក្រោយអ្នកពេលពីថ្ងៃនោះអេមទីគូដែលមានអលជាអ្នកចែកជាប្រធានគុកអឺ at any time after the end of the year, did you ever go back to look at Tulsa Lake?
And just so we're clear here, do I understand correctly that when Yeet came to pick you up at Ol's office, that he took you in his vehicle from Ol's office back to your unit? Is that right? Now, you indicated in the OCIJ interview that I read a few minutes ago that at the time you were picked up, first picked up by the truck, you were at a place called An Long Ka Nyan. Can you tell us where was An Long Ka Nyan and what were you doing at that location?
តើអន្លង់រងានោះឯណាដែរហើយនៅពេលទៅដល់អន្លង់រងានលោកធ្វើអ្វីដែរមុនពេលគេចាប់ខ្លួនលោកនោះនៅអន្លង់រងានហ្នឹងពេលហ្នឹងពេលខ្ញុំចាប់ខ្លួនខ្ញុំហ្នឹងខ្ញុំនៅជាពេទ្យព្យាបាលនៅកន្លែងតាមទីអន្លង់រងានក្មួយកប់ស្រូវដើរព្យាបាលពួកយោធាគេនៅធ្វើស្រែខ្លះនៅកិនម៉ាស៊ីនខ្លះទៀតគេខាង
And could you just give us some sense of where was An Long Ka Nyan? Was it in Phnom Penh or was it outside the city?
ลงกงานนั้นบ่อภพเพียวิรัชนาโตจ314นั้นภพเพียประจําถมในក្នុងទីក្រុងភ្នំពេញតែកន្លែងសាខាគេធ្វើការគ្រប់កន្លែងហ្នឹងចាប់ពីភូមិមីម៉ាយរហូតដល់បឹងយ៉ាបនិងកប់ស្រូវកប់ស្រូវគេដាក់ម៉ាស៊ីនអាឈើហើយម្លងកងានគេដាក់ម៉ាស៊ីន
Uh, So do I understand that this was an area where Division 310 people had been sent to the farm rice?
This is the same area as
Bong Prayap. Thank you for clarifying that,
Mr. Witness.
I want to turn now to some questions about the Kampong-Chenang Airport site that you were, you've already testified that you were sent to that site sometime after your arrest. You testified that you were told you were being sent to this place for tempering or refashioning. What did you understand it to mean when you were told
គេបញ្ជូនទៅពលានយន្តហោះកំពង់ឆ្នាំងហ្នឹងកន្លែងហ្នឹងកន្លែងលោតដំគេថាឲ្យយើងកសាងខ្លួនឲ្យបានផុតពីសេចក្តីស្លាប់បើយើងទៅលោតដំមានការមិនលុតដំមិនយកចិត្តទុកដាក់បើយើងយកជើងដៃដាច់ដៃយកជើងរៀដាច់ជើងព្រោះកន្លែងហ្នឹងគេថាកងចាក់កំពុងទៅវិលអញ្ចឹងយើងត្រូវតែការលោតដំឲ្យ
And how many months in total did you work at the Kampong-Chenang
airport site?
បានបីខែបាទនៅលុតដំកន្លែងនោះបានបីខែបីខែបានគេថាវៀតណាមចូលវាយប្រទេសកម្ពុជាហ្នឹងក៏គេថាអ្នកដែលលុតដំទាំងប្រមាណហ្នឹងក៏សាងខ្លួនបានហើយអញ្ចឹងយើងត្រូវនាំទៅបំពាក់អាវុធវាយកងទ័ពវៀតណាមគេថាកងទ័ពវៀតណាមឈ្លានពានប្រទេសកម្ពុជាបាទ
And the 3 months that you were refashioned at the Kampong-Chenang airport site, was this in 1977 or
1978?
Can you describe for the court the work that you were required to perform during these 3 months that you were at the Kampong-Chenang airport site?
Nau Kampong Chenang nung ke thoe palien yon hoh nung ke ao yeung chich hai nung dot chnuon phnom dam bai ke ao long tha thoe kapal hoh chambang samvap vai khmang dot chnuon nung yeung teu dap chnuon nung dap thmo nung dak chnuon
You indicated that one of your tasks was translated as burning explosives in the mountain in order to get stones.
Can you be a little more specific?
Did you handle explosives yourself? And can you tell the court what it is that you had to do?
Miền mất kê nè chế đọt khi nhóm con này nè đập thơ mò đi. Cô đập thơ mò đã bấy nhọt nguồn nóng châu nóng ruộng thơ mò nâng bà.
So you would break a hole in the rock where the explosive would be put. How was the explosive detonated after you had created this hole and the explosive had been put in? How were these explosives detonated?
Bờ nè nà nơi chết thơm bay thơm mò nó buộc đôi dương khóa bay chăng bà.
Just so I understand, when you said that you would burn them, do you mean that you would... These explosives had a fuse that you would light? Is that how they were set
off?
And how often were workers... injured or killed when these explosives were ignited?
Pel nong kla pung ta chik day man ban chap lap kla ko trau nong bang thmo mien robuh thngun kla ko mien kruh thna che chraen doy sa nong chnuon ktuh nong man ban chap lap ba neak ke dot kê nâng ruột crab bà nẹ đại thừa cả nơi các bài khnếng khnếng ọt bàn đắng cô thật tụ trời bà.
How often during the 3 months you were there, how much of the 3 months did you spend working on the blasting of the rock and the use of these explosives?
Crowd bay mong bun kê oi chỗ tàu tua ka dot snoo nung lho tua mong pin đập ngay trăng ba.
What I was trying to understand was is this something that you did every day during the 3 months you were at Camp Anchanay, or is it something you only worked on for a specific time period?
Thời viên cái nhóm cái ao chuồn cá viên ao tới chị cái chặt tăng mê cái chặt tăng ao tới chị đấy và liền chuồn hó chị lá cái ao tới vài thò bà vua hà nông tam thờ lơ cái mê cái nẹt chặt tăng bà
let me read
ra về nhà
what you said in your OCIJ and you're describing here your work I was sent to Camp On Chanang alone in approximately 1978. They had me make holes in the rock to put dynamites for the blasting. In order to make caves for parking aircrafts, and the rocks were grinded for the airfield runways. On average, 5 to 6 people got injured because of the blasting. I wanted to get some clarification of what you meant when you said that on average, 5 to 6 people got injured. Were you talking about every day, every week, every month? And can you give us a sense of how often people were injured as a result of the dynamite blasting?
បើពេលដុតឈ្នួននឹងបើពេលណាដែលគេត្រូវដុតឈ្នួនច្រើនគឺមានលម្អហើយតែបើដុតឈ្នួនតិចទេអត់ស្ូវមានលម្អទេតែបើគេថាថ្ងៃហ្នឹងត្រូវផែនការថាយើងត្រូវរំលាយថ្មភ្នំហ្នឹងឲ្យខ្លាំងអញ្ចឹងត្រូវមានលម្អហើយបាទ
Okay, I'd like to show you a few photographs that we have from the Camp On Chanang site. Mr. President, would you leave? Let me start with these are photographs that appear in the OCIJ site identification report. E3 8041 E3 8041 at Khmer page 00384449 and there's two photographs on that page that I will show the witness. And with your leave, if I can provide that to the witness, and I think we can also display them on the screen. So there are two photographs on the page I've just handed you, and if we can show the first one on the screen. So the first photograph I want to ask you about, we can see a gentleman pointing, and in the background there is a hill with a rock face. Do you recognize this location, Mr. Witness, and if so, can you tell us what it is?
ti tang nung doi chi mên ka lai khom thua ka ba doi ot skol ka lai nung
Do you know were you working at the same location where you were blasting the rock? Was this the same place that they were making a tunnel into the mountain? Or was that at a different location?
Thưa nơi biển Phuong Hoa nó cái thưa chi rung đạ yun hoa nơi biển nó mong cái lung phnom nó đảm bị tha đạ cái pa hoa chô trong nó cái ở thưa rung ấy cái tha lung chnuôn nó ở cái pa hoa nó thưa biển nó cái pa hoa chô chọt trong nó ba.
And my question to you was the place where this tunnel was being blasted out of the mountain, was that the same place where you were helping to plant explosives?
Cái nhà chi thơ bà liên bà liên nhà đất nì phnom phnom đàm bây cà nà bà liên nâng cái ai thơ ai xa cái tha đàm bây ở cái bà hoa chọc bà.
All right, Mr. President, if we can display on the screen the second photograph. This is from the same page of the OCIJ site identification report E3-8041. If we could show the second photograph. And this is in the same page that I handed to you, Mr. Witness. In this photograph, this individual is pointing to a wall of some sort. And my question for you is, do you remember this location, the wall that this witness is pointing to?
តាលោកមានចាំទីតាំងនេះដែលបរមអ្នកកំពុងចង្អុលហើយមានជាងនេះពេលនោះគាត់គាត់ថ្លៃថាតំជើងឆ្លៃគាត់ទៅនៅមិនជាងដែរនៅនៅភ្នំហ៎ជាងវិញពេលធ្វើនោះយកភ្នំនេះធ្វើរូងហើយអត់យកជាងយកថ្មនឹងយកអាថ្មនឹងយកមកវាយធ្វើពលានយន្តហោះបាទ
Do you remember whether there was whether it was a small hill or a small wall that was built for workers to hide behind when the dynamite exploded? Remember anything like that?
Bởi chám chám mà con thơ mò tui nhưng cái chừng ổn nâng bà thơ mò thông nóng ạc bàn chám ấy bùa bê nóng về mình toàn thơ bấy nhá bà.
Mr. President, I have some additional photographs to show, and these photographs come from To the witness, and I have some questions about the photographs.
Yes, I have a question about the photographs.
Yes, I have a
Mr. Witness, if you can turn to the what is the second photo here, and if we can display it on the screen as well, with your leave, Mr. President. If you could go back to the photo before that one. So the photograph that we're looking at now, is the a hole that was blasted in the side of this mountain. That is the beginning of a tunnel. Do you recognize this location? Do you know if this is the place where you were blasting a rock using dynamite?
Do
you remember how deep at the end of the 3 months that you worked at the site, this tunnel that was being blasted into the mountain, how deep was it at that point in time? How many meters deep was the tunnel into the mountain? If we could now show the next photograph. This is photograph number 3 that appears in OCIJ site report
E3805. If we can show that on screen.
Mr. Witness, this is a photograph that was taken by investigators just after entering the tunnel, the hole that we saw in the previous photograph. At the time that you left the site, do you remember how high was the tunnel that you had built or blasted in the mountain?
Um,
we don't dispute the tunnels, but putting this tunnel to the witness and then leading in and confirming this, this of course not any proper manner in getting out of it. But as I said, we concede that tunnels were being built.
I'm
grateful that council concedes that. I have questions I would like to ask the witness about this process.
I think the photographs give us a picture of what was going on there.
So if I may proceed, Mr. President, my question is, how high was the tunnel at the end of the 3 months that this work worked?
ធ្វើការអស់រយៈពេលបីខែហ្នឹងលោកមកចាំទេថារូងហ្នឹងមានកម្ពស់ប្រមាណម៉ែត្រដែរ
Let me ask you a few more questions before we finish today. You've indicated that you used dynamite, that you had to light a fuse. Did people have to protect themselves and hide before the explosion took place? Do you remember how long you had to get away from the explosion site?
ពេលដុតហ្នឹងគឺដុតភ្លាមហ្នឹងនាំគ្នារត់ដល់រត់ទៅជួនកាលរត់តាន់ជួនកាលរត់អត់តាន់បាទ
Did you, were you aware during the 3 months you were there, whether any people were killed as a result of these explosions?
ខ្ញុំធ្វើការនៅពេលស្លាប់លឺជួនកាលឮគេថាត្រូវចំកញ្ចឹងកមានស្លាប់ដែរតើមិនបានឃើញនឹងភ្នែកតែគេថាមានស្លាប់ព្រោះពេលធ្វើហ្នឹងវាធ្វើចៃ
Mr. President, I was going to turn to some questions about the general conditions. If you want me to continue, I can.
លោកប្រធានតាមការពិតខ្ញុំត្រូវទៅសួរសំណួរឲ្យស្ដីអំពីលក្ខខណ្ឌការងារទូទៅប៉ុន្តែតើខ្ញុំបន្តសួរសំណួរតទៅទៀតបានទេឬក៏ឈប់សិន
បាទអរគុណហើយសំណាកការនៅថ្ងៃនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ហើយអំពីប្រកាសផ្អាកគណៈកម្មការសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃនេះត្រឹមនេះសំណាកការលើកទៅធ្វើថ្ងៃស្អែកថ្ងៃពុទ្ធទី7ខែធ្នូឆ្នាំ2016ដែលនឹងចាប់ផ្ដើមពីម៉ោង9ព្រឹកហើយសំណាកការនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកនេះអនុវត្តនឹងបន្តធ្វើសំណាកការស្ដាប់ប្រតិកម្មរបស់សាស្ត្រីនួនត្រិចបញ្ចប់សូមពីគេជ្រាបនឹងជើងចូលរួមតាមពេលវេលាបានកំណត់នេះអង្គជំរះអរគុណលោកនួនត្រិចសំណាកការស្ ួយនឹងបុគ្គលិកនៃអង្គភាពកម្ពុជាសាក់សៃនិងអ្នកជំនាញក្នុងការជូនសាក់សៃទៅត្រឡប់ទៅកៃតឡៃគាត់ថ្នាក់នៅហើយនឹងអញ្ជើញគាត់ត្រឡប់ចូលរួមសាក់ផ្ដល់សក្ខីកម្មនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកទៀតដែលតំណងជាតែមួយវគ្គសមាការនៃព្រឹកស្អែកនោះទេហើយបង្កប់ឲ្យអនុរដ្ឋមន្ត្រីឃុំឃាំងនាំខ្លួនជនជាប់ចោទទៅពីរូបលោកនួនជាតិនិងលោកខៀវសំផនត្រឡប់ទៅកាន់មន្ត្រីឃុំឃាំងនៃអវតកវិញចុះនឹងបង្កប់ឲ្យនាំខ្លួនគាត់ត្រឡប់ចូលរួមសកម្មភាពនៅថ្ងៃស្អែកឲ្យបានមុនម៉ោង9ព្រឹកសម្រាប់ចុះ